Welcome to part 4 of Let's Play a SpongeBob SquarePants movie game. Alright, so it's 3,000 miles to Shell City. And just so you know, this is the same as the driving stages, only the fiddle part is not included.
Now I can teach you the Bashmere.
Now I am the master.
Wow, that's amazing.
Those radio towers are broadcasting Plankton's hypnotizing messages. If we don't do something soon, every creature in the sea will be under Plankton's control. You have to go into the desert and shut them down.
Isn't this the really dangerous desert that no one has ever returned from?
No. I think that's the desert next to this one.
Oh! Well, in that case, I'll have those towers shut down in a jiffy.
Oh, no. Patrick, what are you doing? Don't hit him! Leave it alone! Alrighty, can't hit him. He was warned! Just so you know, you can send projectiles back at enemies when your karate spin is upgraded. Woo! Got him! Serves you right!
That's a headache waiting to happen.
And this is for this guy! Two for the price of one? No problem! Okay, that was a bad idea. Come on. That was also a bad idea! Where'd you go this time? Eat your own goo! Ah, crap! Okay, eat it this time! There you go! Ah, nuts! Okay! Try it again. Let's see if I can hit all three of these balls up at the same time. Ah, crap. Plankton? Killed mid-sentence. And no one cares of what you want, who you want captured. Am I right, people? I'm telling you, this is one of my favorite Nickelodeon games. And for a movie licensed game, this is pretty darn good. Okay, those like guys, like from the gas station and everything, they're jerks. Jerks. And I'll say it again, jerks. Okay, for those of you who have not played Battle for Bikini Bottom, Sponge Ball was one of SpongeBob's abilities, which means you can, like, hit a ball, well, hit a ball, like, hit a ball icon of SpongeBob, and he'll immediately turn into a ball. And if you hit something, or jump over, or hit the, well, actually, hit the jump button, you'll immediately turn back into regular SpongeBob. Oh, good! The hardest part of the Sponge Ball in Battle for Bikini Bottom was that when you were timed in Rock Bottom, and you have to make your way. Now apparently controls weren't as tight. Actually, they're not as tight. It's just darn hard. Huh? I rhymed again. Darn hard. Okay. Just gotta time this right. Come on, no. There we go. No deaths. There you go, people. We gotta admit that is pretty easy. I managed to beat all of the floaty block challenges in the game. Boom! I don't think I was able to beat all the sponge ball challenges. The last one was kind of hard. Well, the steam pushes you around in sponge ball mode. Oh no, don't die! Come on. And you know what I also managed to do? That line was used in Creature from the Krusty Krab. Literally, I don't even know why Blitz Games did that. Blitz Games did take note from these games. I'll give it that. Blitz Games. Just so you know, if you don't know who Blitz Games are, there's like this game company that shut down, about 4 years ago. They developed the Fairly OddParents games, you know, Shadow Showdown and Breaking the Rules, and Creature from the Krusty Krab, well, SpongeBob Creature from the Krusty Krab, and his latest Grimpantis, and like another Kinect game. I don't even know what it's called. Neither do I care. I play Creature from the Krusty Krab. It's pretty awesome. It's weird, but awesome. So nobody listen to the general public. Go get Creature from the Krusty Krab. It may just turn out to be one of your favorites. It is one of my favorites now because I played it. It's pretty fun. I mean, you can play as Plankton for the first time. You go all these like crazy dreams and such. And I will not spoil the ending for you guys. Well, for those who haven't played it yet, if any of you, I know a lot of you guys have played it because it came out in 06. I didn't even have a liking for video games at first. But I think when I first moved here, like to my house right here in Suffolk, that's when I got that. My sister Allison had a PS2, the same PS2 that I'm playing on right now, but she never played it much. So after Allison never played her PS2 anymore, I found it in one of the boxes and I snagged it up. The first game I ever played it was Powerpuff Girls Relish Rampage. And I'm talking about from the 1998 series, not the 2016 reboot. I mean, to be honest, it's good. The reboot is good in my opinion. To some of y'all, to a lot of y'all, it may not. I mean, I also like the 1998 series. Heck, I got the whole series on DVD. Yeah, you know, the 10th anniversary collection. So World's Rampage was the first PlayStation 2 game I ever owned. Then I got rid of it. Cause I just got tired in my opinion, and it was kinda hard. Then I also got Rocket Power Beach Bandits. I still have it, it's pretty fun. It's a really good Rocket Power game. Little extreme, but good. Well, you gotta admit, Rocket Power is about extremeness. Whee! Okay, I gotta get this done. Because I don't have time to mope around or anything. Well, not mope around. Just like fool around. You have to be very careful on these, because they shift, spin, rotate. Well, actually, rotate and spin are the same thing. Well, they like rotate like this. And they do that. So you gotta time it exactly right. And sometimes these are very hard to get up there. But I have played this game enough times. And it took me a long time to beat this. Okay, why is this even up here? Here we go! Go back. Come on, game, hurry up. I don't have all video. Did I see Patrick? Oh, I did not see Patrick. Just so you guys know. Okay, no, that's probably a bad idea. Yeah, that is probably a bad idea. Come on, don't die. Come on, let's go. There we go, got it. Thank you. right.
This hurts me more than it hurts you, radio tower.
And boom! Come on. That's the end of part 4, guys.